Let the music groove you, let the melody move you, feel the beat and just let go, get the rhythm into your soul. Let the music take you anywhere it wants to. Come on, come on, turn up the music. Turn Up the Music from the Lemonade Mouth soundtrack captures the very feeling I get when I listen to music. I can't help but move to the rhythm. It's like the music runs through my body like blood runs through my veins. I cry literal tears when I hear a good beat or melody. I'm not even exaggerating. You can ask any member of my family. Ever since I was little, music has been a huge part of my life. Music is what brought my parents together. My dad started a rap group called 7-9 when he was a teenager in Los Angeles, California, where he was from. And my mom lived in Mobile, Alabama, where she was raised. Well, long story short, my dad had a concert at my mom's home church. They fell in love, blah, 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 and created the greatest miracle known to man. Me. No, I'm just kidding. That's for another speech. Whether my dad is producing a beat, my brother's beatboxing and freestyling, my mom playing oldies from her teenage years, or me singing at the top of my lungs in my room, music is constantly in our home. I can't remember a time when it wasn't. In this speech, I'm going to be informing you on the power of music. The first point being how music affects us mentally and emotionally. And lastly, how the Lord uses music to give praise and glorify Him. Imagine you're listening to one of your favorite songs, tapping your foot along to the beat and snapping to the rhythm. Hey, even if you're not the best singer, you're still belting out all the parts of the melody. But what causes our bodies to react this way in the first place? Columbia University neurologist John Krakauer, in an article titled, Why We Like to Dance and Move to the Beat, says, quote, music is known to stimulate pleasure and reward areas, like the orbitofrontal cortex, located directly behind one's eyes, as well as the midbrain region called the ventral striatum. In particular, the amount of activations in these areas matches up with how much we enjoy the tunes. In addition, music activates the cerebellum at the base of the brain, which is involved in the coordination and timing of movement, end quote. Now, I know there was a lot of information in that article, but basically what it is saying is that when we listen to music, it triggers the parts of our brains that are involved in decision-making, reward processing, and movement. Hey, that's pretty cool if I do say so myself. Scientific research also shows that the same part of our brain that processes speech also processes music. In an article from thehealthline.com, it tells us exactly how the cerebellum part of our brain works. It says, quote, the cerebellum coordinates voluntary movements such as posture, coordination, balance, and speech, resulting in a smooth and balanced muscular activity, end quote. So if the same part of our brains that process speech also process music, is music a language? Pacific Standard Magazine published an article titled, Is Music a Language? And in the article, they tell us about a very unique science experiment conducted by researchers at Johns Hopkins University. In the experiment, one musician slid into an MRI machine with a plastic keyboard on their lap and played a piece of jazz, while another musician in the control room played along with them, taking turns playing solos. It says, quote, during the improvisations, the areas that interpret the structure of sentences were super active, as if the two musicians were speaking to each other. Because our brains don't discriminate between music and language structurally, we may in fact understand all forms of communication in the same way, end quote. Now, I enjoy a very large variety of music. Pop, rap, R&B, Christian, gospel, Broadway, folk, Korean pop, electronic dance music, and much, much more. Some of the music I like to listen to isn't necessarily in English. I don't have to understand the lyrics to feel the emotion behind the song. I have recently joined the worship team at my home church. This is my first time singing in four-part harmony. A lot of the times on Sundays, whoever is leading the song will improvise when ad-libbing. And let me tell you, this is when everyone starts to feel the emotion and starts to worship wholeheartedly. But what's the meaning behind this deep emotion? Neurologist and musician Alan Harvey gave a TED Talk in 2018 titled Your Brain on Music. And in the speech, he said something that completely blew my mind. He says, quote, "The levels of a hormone called oxytocin in the bloodstream are raised when people are singing together. But particularly when singers are improvising together," end quote. The oxytocin hormone is connected to relationship building, trust, and empathy. So basically, when we're singing with each other, we can build better relationships and trust. So far, we went over how our brains process music, and we went over how it affects us emotionally. But what does music have to do with our mental development? Well, when I was in elementary and middle school, I was enrolled in a homeschooling program called Classical Conversations. The subjects we learned were math, English, science, Latin, history, and geography. The way they had us learn all that information was through music. Every week, we had a new fact to learn under those subjects, and every week, there was a song that went along with what we were studying. I can still tell you how English King John signed the Magna Carta in 1215. I wouldn't be able to remember any of that information if it wasn't put to song. In an article from mytruesis.com titled The Powerful Effects of Music on Memory, it says, quote, "When music is paired with everyday activities, it can help those with memory loss develop a rhythm that can help them recall doing the activity and improve their ability to do it over time," end quote. I have been singing ever since I was a little girl. And before my family moved to Montgomery, Alabama, we lived in California for 9 years of my life. And my parents were the youth pastors at the church we used to go to while we lived there. And I was in the youth choir. We were called the King's Kids Choir. I can still remember the songs we used to sing, the performances we used to give, and the fun my friends and I had singing. Even though it might have been so long ago, I can still remember that feeling. Neurologist Oliver Sacks says that, quote, "Music evokes emotion. An emotion can bring with it memory. It brings back the feeling of life like nothing else can," end quote. The Lord gave us this wonderful outlet of communication, not only to connect with each other, but also to connect with our Heavenly Father. Whether it's Christian rap that confesses sin, gospel that shouts and repeats the attributes of God, or worship that dwells in the sweet love of our Savior Jesus Christ, the Lord gave us music to give praise and glorify Him. Psalms 105, 1 through 5 says that, quote, "Praise the Lord in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His mighty deeds. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. Praise Him with trumpet sound. Praise Him with lute and harp. Praise Him with tambourine and dance. Praise Him with loud crashing cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord," end quote. One of my favorite worship songs, So Will I, 100 Billion X by Hillsong United, breaks down so sweetly how that everything God created sings His praises. "I can see your heart and everything you've made. Every burning star, a signal fire of grace. If creation sings your praises, so will I." I pray that this speech gave you a new outlook on music. So next time you're jamming out to one of your favorite songs, get up and move, sing along, and let your body react to music the way the Lord created it to. Thank you so much.